Chaos has come to Will Sinatra Facebook.
How would I describe the state of the world today?
Chaotic. From relationships to the media.
For persons to find. And if we would just get back to the Word of God, we would see how our relationships...
I will graduate from high school.
I have graduated.
No? We think you're done?
Excuse me.
How old are you?
14?
Yes, she's 14.
I don't know nothing yet, you understand?
I'm
just studying on people. I don't want to hear none of that. Okay?
Sports. You're with the Department of Sports here in the Cayman Islands.
Yep.
What is your take on that?
Chaos in sports.
Spare not the rod, they say. Not these days. Classrooms are very chaotic.
You see, what happened is people, God made us creatures of choice, right? And people choose chaos.
But in the world right now.
Wow. Chaos in the world.
One of the things that came to my mind was when the devil came here. Right, and he lost the
fucking yeah, well, go on, okay, man. Yes, and then he then stepped down.
In order to get recognized, you sometimes have to move above and beyond.
Boy, I'm tired of this now. It holds the world.
Yeah, man, I'm in the most crash. I don't know what my brother did. I'm a kid.
This is a Will Sinatra, God First Bro production.
Hi, I'm Vanessa. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
The world today?
Coming next, it's a world of chaos. Chaos is everywhere, from Grand Cayman to the world. Will Sinatra and his iPhone will take you to the places where chaos rules. Get ready for it right now. It's a rainy Monday morning. My alarm goes off. My day off today. My day off from work. But I had to wake up early to begin this journey. A journey to explore what is causing havoc in this world.
How would I describe the state of the world today? Actually, that's quite an easy one. The world today is in total chaos.
I'm a kid.
is breaking news.
Breaking news. We are getting last-minute reports from all over the world of thousands of people that have just vanished. I repeat, thousands of people from all over the globe have disappeared.
Chaos. Flooding the world right now. Knowing the Bible and everything, you know, chaos is something that I expect to happen in the world before Jesus comes again. And I mean, we have ISIS, we have chaos in the shops, people are running down, self-adorning themselves, Putin, Russia bombing Syria, you name it. And it leads many to wonder, will these things lead to World War III? Will it lead to destruction of the world? But I'm promised by God that yes, these things will happen, but in the last days that I should look up, for that's where my help comes from. And I'm reminded every day when I read the Bible that despite the chaos that surrounds me, my friends, yourself, that we have a hope in Jesus that one day this chaos will come to an end. So look up. That's where our redemption comes from.
Hi everyone, this is Althea and you're watching Chaos in the World.
Yes, it's a mad world, I tell you. But how we choose to live in it or through it, but not of it, will determine our way forward. Fearless are some of us in this uncertain time. We move, though, through life. Yes, enjoying the beauty, sometimes forgetting the chaos that is around us. We work hard, we rest, we awake, even have time to take our favorite selfies sometimes. Yet again, forgetting the chaos around us, we attempt to smile. But is the smile real? That is the question. The innocence of the world. Where is it?
The premier's statement in the legislative assembly is concerning to the religious community, as he promises that his government will speedily seek to make legislation to facilitate homosexual lifestyle and practices here in Cayman Islands.
Yeah, well, go on. You hear what's going on, Cayman? Yes, Anthony, you didn't step down.
What has Cayman come to?
What you say? What has Cayman come to? That's the question I bother asking, boy. Anyway, got time now. I'm on the road, so I'll talk to you later, right? Later.
Traffic chaos, political chaos. It is enough to drive us crazy and get us depressed.
My name is Shayari and you're watching Chaos in the World.
Yep. Chaos.
Chaos. On the subject of depression. Loneliness. Low self-esteem. Unachieving goals. Just simply troubled. Nobody to reach out to. Your life is in a chaotic mess. If there is only someone that you can talk to right now.
Hello, can I help?
I'm tired of this now. Everything I put my hands in this world, I always seem to mess it up. Nowhere in this world.
Oh Lord, woman, stop worrying yourself. What are you worrying yourself for? Everything will be alright, man. Just live on your knees. Like I keep telling you, worrying, it never brings any positive to a situation. I mean, the only thing it does is sickens you. So you want to add to the madness right now. Stop worrying yourself, man. Live on your knees. Pray, believe everything will be alright. You want things to be alright, you pray for it, man. Pray. Spend more time praying than worrying.
Chaos.
Hi, I'm Shonda Gallego, and you're watching Chaos in the World.
You see, what happened is people, God made us creatures of choice, right? And people choose chaos. You see, when you choose to rule a God, you open the doors to all sorts of chaos. But people choose that. I mean, it's written in the Bible that the light came into the world and the world comprehended it not, because people like darkness. They choose darkness rather than light. And that way all chaos comes from. So the only thing you can do is unplug. That's it, unplug. That's it.
Hi, this is Aisha. Hope you're enjoying the show.
I'm a sports fan. Yes, I enjoy watching basketball. Love the Celtics, one of the greater teams in the NBA. So I want to get somebody's perspective on chaos in the world of sports.
Chaos in sports. Well, you know, I would say that one of the fortunate things about sports is that I think more than 90% of people, when they participate in sports, they're there because they actually want to be there, mm-hmm. right? So when they want to be there, they understand that there are rules and regulations that govern a particular sport. And in essence, the game cannot go on unless you are complying with the rules. So I think in terms of that, that's really, really good. But nonetheless, sports is a reflection of life because it contains people. And so naturally, people bring their temperaments, they bring their personalities, they bring what they're made of in sport. As a matter of fact, Aristotle said that you can learn more about a person in 1 hour of play than 10 hours of conversation, because when they're put in certain situations in sports, the real them has to come out. They don't have any time to really think about disguising it. It's just that reaction, right? But in terms of chaos, I mean, what I would consider that is when people may try to cause confusion or disorganization. So you have situations, for example, people that use performance enhancing drugs, right, where they don't want to go down the route where they abide by the ethics, by the moral standards, just giving your all and just giving your best and seeing where it lies. Work harder if you have to, but some people want the accolades, they want the recognition, they want the prestige of excelling or dominating in their particular sport or their event. And they're not willing to work as hard as they need to work naturally to achieve those results.
Chaotic.
Hi, my name is Yashik Gordon, and you're watching Chaos in the World.
Chaos in the classroom. Chaos in the classroom. I have no voice. I'm the adult here. So why am I having to obey you?
A mother, teacher, counselor, nurse. She's everything.
Do I get acknowledged? Not really. Maybe an extra week's vacation. A raise. Probably every 10 years. The children?
They are awesome.
Do I love my job? Yes, I love my job. Is it chaotic? Yes, it is. Behavioral issues. Spare not the rod, they say. Not these days. Classrooms are very chaotic.
Hi everyone, I am Giselle and you're watching Chaos in the World.
Somebody asked me the other day, what is your thought on the present situation in terms of the generation of now in comparison to the generation that you are a part of, say in middle school, high school? What was my reply? Ah, boy.
Tell the truth, the way I see some of these young people carrying on, if they are the future, then trust me, the future is in trouble.
At 14 years old, they counted me by one.
Yeah. How old an is? 14?
Yeah, she 14.
I don't know nothing yet, you understand?
She
I'm just telling you, people.
Young lady, you don't need me talk to you all?
No, who you think you're talking to?
Excuse me. Excuse me?
Now my mother and my father can tell me what do, so what makes you think you can tell me what do?
Get up before I talk to you. You don't know my mother?
Try come out my face. Come
hello, I'm a bigger person than you.
Try come out my face before me, you fight.
Are you serious right now?
Yes, I'm very serious.
How old are you?
You don't need know that.
I guess it's safe to say that they created their own rules. And I guess their parents, the elders, should live by those rules. Is that what I'm hearing? Is that what I'm understanding? The generation now, man, you chastise and they want to call the police saying you're being abusive. That's the power we give to them.
But let's be fair. In a world of chaos, sometimes there's calm. To those young people out there who are level-headed, you are the ones who make the future seems worthwhile.
I will graduate from high school.
I have graduated from high school.
Not all of us are negative. I will graduate from university.
I will respect authority.
I'll be graduating when I'll turn 17.
Hi, my name is Johanna Eugene, and you're watching Chaos in the World.
There's a lot of things these days that are destroying relationships. I would think the main one would be self. People today are all about self, what I can get. And in terms of a relationship, what I can get out of this relationship, where God established a relationship or marriages for both persons to uplift each other. And, you know, if I'm trying to get what I can from the next person and they're doing that as well, there's not going to be unity in the relationship. There's going to be discord. This is going to cause arguments. This is going to cause conflict. I mean, there's numerous things that this can cause.
Chaos, my friend, is no respecter of persons or situation. From a relationship to the workplace, it rears its ugly head.
Wow. Chaos in the workplace. In order to get recognized, you sometimes have to go above and beyond. And even in that recognition, that's never good enough. There are the office politics, there are the clear ceilings, and there's that, oh, I don't want to go to work. There are co-workers you may not get along with, and you can't just throw in the towel and say, I'm not coming back. You need that job to pay those bills. Chaos in the workplace is like a ball and chain. That's chaos in the workplace.
Hi, my name is Ron Stewart, and you're watching Chaos in the World.
A remote control gives us access to a world of chaos in black and white, or even in color.
Welcome to the Wilson Natural Radio Show. The subject is chaos. Chaos when it comes to the media. I have a very special guest. Doesn't want to be seen on the camera, so we won't put him on the camera. But what is your opinion on chaos when it comes to the media?
Some would dare say that the media is biased and agenda-driven, with a strong left-wing liberal lean. Just because it's in black and white doesn't mean it's necessarily the truth. Thus, chaos could be the result of any manipulation or orchestration. A great deal of it is politically correctness. It's driven by the media, not society.
Chaos is so easily accessed in the eyes. Televisions, radio, the media on a whole. But be careful what
you are fed. That is, the media tends to feed you with what they want to feed you. Sometimes, far from the truth. Objects in the rearview mirror are closer than they appear. Don't be a part of the media's propaganda. Know the truth. Follow the truth.
Tell you something, ISIS and all these other things that are going on in the world, it's just the enemy's pawns, you know, in his temper tantrum. Why is he throwing a temper tantrum? Because he knows his time is short. He knows that he's fighting a losing battle. And sometimes I just imagine him just sitting there saying, man, no matter what I do, no matter how I try to come against the people of God, because you look at ISIS, who do they hate? They hate Christians. They're going around putting Christians in cages, setting them on fire, cutting their heads off. You know, that's who they're looking for. Why? Because the enemy hates us, because he's jealous, because we have the light and the fire of God inside of us. So he's trying to come against us with fear. He's trying to come against us with division. That's why you got ISIS and Black Lives Matter and racism and all this mess that's going on in the world that cause division and fear. You know, even with the Christians, some of them are getting caught up in that agenda. Some of them don't even see what's happening. You're just being a part of the pawn of the enemy. He's trying to cause a distraction because he knows his time is short. He knows he's fighting a losing battle. There's chaos going on all over in the world. The Bible says when you see these things happening, look to the sky for your redemption draw nigh.
This is a generation for many, where they are placed in a den of hungry lions. Your survival depends on the strength of your faith.
Pray, ask God for the way, and you know, he'll find a way for you. Yeah, man. Take it easy. Alright.
I thank you for that. I really do. Thank you so much.
One of the things that came to my mind was when the devil came here, right? And we lost the battle for our original sin. When he went to the unfallen worlds, they didn't accept him. Did they not accept him because their worlds were already populated and they already had their structure going and they were already fully committed to God? They were like, no, we don't want you here. And because did they make that decision based upon what they saw in heaven?
If I had to say what I think all this happened prior to any other worlds.
Okay.
That's what I would think. And then upon Satan being cast out, God would probably create worlds, and then he was like, you know, and guess what? That's how he warned Adam and Eve about the deceiver. He would have warned them.
Right.
And then they took heed to his warnings. Mm-hmm. So when the devil came by, you know, they said, we heard about you. Mm-hmm. We don't want you here.
There will always be chaos in our world, but it's up to me and you to have that ultimate faith to counteract any or every chaos that might come our way. That is the moral of this story. Thanks for watching.
What is raging at my feet? I can feel the breath of those surrounding me.
I can hear
the sound of nations rising up. We will not be overtaken. We will not be overcome. I can
you are going to kill him. Yes, and then he then step down.
Crash! I don't know what my brother did. I don't know. I can't take it.
Boy, I'm tired of this now. Everything I put my hands in this world,
The same power that rose Jesus from the grave. The same power that commanded dead to wake lives in us. Lives in us. The same power that moves mountains when he speaks. The same power that can calm a raging sea lives in us. Lives in us.
Hi, I'm Shonda Gallego, and you're watching Chaos.
You're about to get to know the man named... What's his name again?
Hi, this is Vanessa. Sit back, relax, enjoy the show.
One man traveling into your world. Get ready to behold undiscovered beauty, that which you crave to be a part of, in one solid 30 minutes. A documentary put together by a master storyteller. Spellbinding. Even funny at times. Exciting, informing. This documentary will set the record straight. Get ready to know the man. Get ready to be a part of this process. A documentary for the ages. This is it. Coming soon to Will Sinatra Facebook. Getting to know Will Sinatra.
I is gone mentally, no, physically, yeah.